Lovely morning. Well, it's still Breakfast Daily, and City TV is the only place to be tuned in right now. We are going to be talking nutrition this morning, and I've been joined by my guest, Akosua Kunedu-Yiadom. I will introduce her in just a little bit, but you know, Valentine's is coming up, and it's exciting times. You know, people are thinking of different things to do and so on and so forth. Well, there's also the issue of desserts and fun foods that we can enjoy that are also healthy, you know, that we can enjoy in this season, you know. So Akosua Kunedu is with us. She's a state registered nutritionist, and she's going to help us to understand some of these delicacies that we can enjoy at this time. Good morning, Akosua.
Good morning, Kweku.
How are you?
Okay.
All right. It's good to have you here.
Always a pleasure.
Now, take us into the season of love and the food habits that we should preferably engage in as far as the good nutrition and good the drinks, food, and so on. We want to talk about our local palace, we say yoyi. Velvet tamarind, yeah. That's what it's called, right? Yeah, so tell us about that.
Okay, so I always say that we are blessed as a people, we are blessed as a continent. Africa has a lot to offer us as far as staying healthy and eating, like as far as eating what we have here and staying healthy is concerned.
Yeah.
We have everything from food to culture, and for nutrition, I want to narrow it to what we are putting into our bodies as far as feeding is concerned. We have everything. We are blessed. We are one of the few continents. As a matter of fact, two countries in the world has what we call prekese galbanum.
Okay.
Yes, and Ghana is one. So we are such a blessed country and a continent as a whole. And for the month of love, yes, we need to be loving other people, but I can love you, Kweku, if I love myself. I'm supposed to love myself first before I can extend that love. And so for love or February, yes, we need to love, but in loving, are we loving our body so much that we are feeding everything that we think our bodies, if they were, my body was like Kweku would smile because I gave my body something,
the best
of treatment as far as what I'm consuming is concerned. So whatever you put in your mouth as far as love is concerned, ask yourself, is your body smiling or frowning?
Well, so to help us to understand, what are some of the amazing benefits that we can have?
Okay, yoyi is amazing. I love nutrition so much that, Kweku, you studied nutrition last year. Today, something has been added on. And in as much as I know that we are blessed as a people, as far as what we have here, what we are eating is concerned,
yes.
I fell in love with yoyi because I was like, this thing you can just buy 50 pesos, one city has all these benefits in there. Yoyi is very good, and that's so, what we have on our table,
yeah.
And on our screen, sorry.
Velvet tamarind.
Yes, and Kweku has given us the English name, Kweku US Scholar. Yes, yoyi helps us. It has antioxidant properties because it is rich in vitamin C.
Okay.
So vitamin C helps as far as taking care of scurvy is concerned, sore throat, sore in the mouth. Yes, vitamin C is good for the skin. It helps us with amazing benefits. And so once vitamin C is in, I am already in love with yoyi because
okay.
It also serves us with anti-inflammatory and then antimicrobial benefits. Why am I saying that? It prevents them because it is blessed with vitamin C or the vitamin ascorbic acid. Yes, aside that, it's good for people with diabetes, especially those who even use the leaves. Yes, so the leaves...
The leaves of the tree.
The leaves of the tamarind
okay.
tree.
Okay.
So you realize that what we know is just the fruit,
yes.
Eating from the pulp. But the whole tree serves amazing benefits. So
wow.
Let's talk about the fruit in itself before we come to the leaves or
okay.
even the stem back.
Okay.
Yes, for the fruit... Yes, you can make a juice out of the tamarind fruit.
Mm-hmm.
And then a juice can be you having a few, let's say a handful, two handfuls of the fruit.
Yeah.
Just take the black part off to be left with the pulp.
Okay.
Yes, then you soak it for, let's say, 5 minutes with water, obviously.
Mm.
You can use a liter of water. Yes, so this is a glass of yoyi juice.
Okay.
So you soak your yoyi with water for 5 minutes, and then now you by the time you take it, you would have gotten the pulp off the seed.
Okay.
Now you crush as you grinding, but we can't obviously ground because we have the hard seeds in there.
Okay.
So you just strain it, and some people will just add cubes. Mm. But for people who have sweeter butts, they would want to add, let's say, a teaspoon of honey to it to just improve on it. You can slot in a bit of mint, just twist it how you want it. But you are getting something amazing from this juice you just made. And it's serving you with benefits as far as your blood pressure is concerned, as far as your insulin levels in people with diabetes mellitus. So you are checking your blood sugar.
Yeah.
You are regulating your insulin levels. The reason why there is diabetes is because there is insulin resistance. Mm. So your body's ability to process this insulin becomes a problem, or it is tampered with. And so if you are getting all these benefits from this simple fruit, why don't you eat your yoi when they are in season?
Mm.
So make sure the next time your yoi is in season, you are just munching on your yoi, but doing it in moderation.
Okay. So let's talk about the rest of the plant. What else can we get?
Okay, so for the leaves, you can squeeze what normally, when I was young, they called this leaf a champon. I don't know the English name for it. So you squeeze, you try to crush it with your hands, and then with what comes, the small liquid that comes on, you can just rub it on the affected place as far as any inflammation is concerned.
Okay.
And then it will take care of it and make sure your skin gets back to where it was. Obviously, most of these things we are not allowed to put it so much out there because there isn't, let's say, 1,000 research work supporting some of these things. It's only based on reviews that few people have been able to do. So it's a challenge to us, or somebody has researched about it. We can all do it as a people so that we can fully appreciate the benefits we are talking about. And for the stem backs, people chop it off and then they make what we call locally concoction. But it's just you adding water and then bringing it to boil. So you fetch, let's say, a glass, probably morning and evening, and it serves you with amazing benefits. It helps with the general overall well-being of us as individuals. When we talk about overall, it has something to do as far as your immunity is concerned. It has something to do as far as you feeling fit, you feeling strong. It affects your head, it affects your limbs, it affects everything that has to do with me as Akosia, with you as Kweku. Yes, and it's amazing benefit to gastric relief.
Okay, that too. Fantastic. Yeah. Okay, so that's great. I mean, I love the yoyi fruit.
Nice.
Velvet tamarind is, I'm not even sure how to describe whether it's sweet or it's not, you know, but it's
on enjoyable. Level. Yes, I love it.
And it's one of those fruits that when you just want to mindlessly distract yourself, and you know, you can just be
low on calories too. So you don't even hear anything when it comes to calories as far as your yeast is concerned. So it's something that is very, very, very
fantastic.
Healthy.
Okay, so let's now talk about healthy desserts.
Yes.
Because I made a promise to Jifa.
Mm-hmm.
I was going to splurge on her on
Valentine's Day. Okay.
Yeah, chocolates.
We don't want Jifa to be bigger after Valentine.
No, I'm bringing chocolates.
Just chocolate.
Yes, but well, I mean, give me some ideas.
Okay, so
some healthy desserts that I can add to the chocolate combo.
I know people will love cakes. People will love to have their juices. Fruits. Why fruits on Valentine's Day? But I always say that food is about how you make it.
Okay.
You can twist it. I can decide to have mangoes. You can decide to have a spread of chocolate on it or add some ice cream to it so that you create something beautiful out of the regular mangoes we have. The reason why it is very difficult for some of our children especially, or those growing up who accept certain things, is that we always present oranges in the same way. We always present our foods in the same way, and it becomes too much for them. Okay, every day I'm taking this, that. But what if we twist them?
Okay.
So for the dessert, I have some images, and then once we have gluten-free cake. We have banana cake.
Okay.
Yes, we have gluten-free sponge cake. And you realize that there is this fuss about gluten-free.
Mm-hmm.
Gluten in itself is not bad.
Okay.
Yes, research says that you deny yourself certain benefits as far as iron, niacin is concerned and other nutrients if you strip off gluten. But you see some of these companies, there is this huge one in Ghana now, and they are selling a lot of supplements saying it's gluten-free. If you are gluten intolerant, then you are not supposed to take gluten.
Okay.
Yes, if you are allergic to wheat, then you don't have to take gluten. If your body doesn't accept the gluten, you don't have to take it. But if, what I'll tell you is that if your body accepts the gluten, take it, but make sure they are taking it in minimal dosage, because there is another research saying that it is harmful. There is other saying that you are depriving your body of certain vital interest, nutrients. Sorry. So why do I have to stay off because everybody is staying off, even if it does something good for my body?
Okay.
Because I don't want to be anemic or have iron deficiency. I don't want to suffer from any of the B vitamins, which have powerful nutrients our body would need for general functioning, the brain, everything about our body. When you say overall health or general health, it means that it affects from the crown of your head to the soles of your feet. It has amazing benefits for the whole body.
Yeah.
So if your body accepts it, work with it. Don't go gluten-free because everybody is going gluten-free. And then, yes, we have another example. Can we have another example on our screen? We have banana cake. Obviously, okay. Banana is rich with potassium. Yeah. Rich with fiber, and it's rich with other wonderful nutrients. And last week we spoke extensively about potassium as far as, I don't want to go there again, but general overall well-being, it boosts sexual performance and other things. So make sure you are eating something that is very healthy. So you can have banana cake for Jifa. Aside potassium, we have it being very, very good as far as vitamin C is also concerned, and it helps when you are treating even people with anemia.
Okay.
Yes. And then we have another dessert. Yes, we have Greek yogurt cake. I love yogurt because it is blessed with probiotics and curcumin.
Nice.
And new we
looks
so
nice.
With this, yes, Jifa, did I say Jifa Kweku? You can get this for Jifa because probiotic will help Jifa as even a woman for her bone health. Because, yes, women...
I'm not sure Jifa is exactly thinking about bone health on Valentine's Day.
Jifa is concerned. Oh, because we need to be giving Jifa a treat, but we still have to make sure Jifa is eating something very healthy. It contains calcium.
Greek yogurt cake.
It contains calcium. Calcium is good.
Okay.
Jifa, we are making sure you have healthy bones, yes. And Kweku, we all are having healthy bodies, healthy bones. So Greek yogurt is very good. Yogurt is very blessed with probiotics. I spoke about it. They are good for anti-inflammation. They are good for microbial infections. So, yes, you are serving your body some goodness in your quest to just have fun. As far as eating something sweet is concerned, we have blueberry cake. It's
blueberry cake.
Yes.
Okay.
Blueberries are seriously amazing. They are blessed with a lot of benefit. They are blessed with a lot of antioxidants.
Okay.
And we know that antioxidants help as far as taking care of free radicals in our bodies are concerned.
Yes.
So once free radicals are out of your body, Kweku, your risk of having some cancers are taken care of, because some of these cancers we have as a result of some of these free radicals which finds its way into our bodies. Don't we have other examples? You can make fruit cake, you can have your bowl of mango. I said when you want to go sweet on fruits, go sweet. When you want to stay acidic, go acidic. So for Valentine, you want to go sweet. So we can have mangoes with pawpaw, and then we have grated chocolates or melted chocolate on it. Just something just to make sure your chocolate is in there. So for, yes, the first one is the melted chocolate, and the second one is the grated. So for your cake, you can even have a spread of a tablespoonful or two tablespoonfuls of that, and you are serving your body with some amazing benefit as far as even the chocolate too is concerned. Because Kweku, we both know that chocolate is good for our blood pressure.
Yes.
It lowers our cholesterol. And it's very, very good for the heart, too, as far as your blood pressure is concerned.
And I particularly like dark chocolate. So, yeah, and I know that's...
So buy her dark chocolate. Buy me dark chocolate.
No,
buy your lovers dark chocolate.
Hold,
make sure you give them a treat as far as everything we've spoken about is concerned.
No,
why no, Kweku?
Hold on. Okay.
Why? All comments reserved.
So, are there any other desserts we should be looking at? The general mindset, I think... you're driving at is for us to remain healthy,
yeah,
you know, and health conscious as we go through a season where we can easily let our guard down.
Yep.
Yeah. Okay. So tell us a little bit about chocolate and its benefits. Because I know that Valentine's Day, a lot of people will consume a lot of chocolate. Yeah.
So I'm very excited that you asked me about chocolate. Chocolates are they are loaded. As much of it affects your blood pressure, your cholesterol. It takes care of even depression, Kweku, and then it prevents or provide anti-aging effects. It serves as a natural stimulant. So there are people, for me, when I'm even struggling to sleep, I have to go in for something that will stimulate me and make me sleep. Chocolate, well, yes. So chocolate is a stimulant. Milo is a stimulant. So it helps as far as people who even have issues with having a good sleep is concerned. And even in the points, it's also there. So for people who want to gain weight too, is a very healthy way of gaining weight. So you have people going in for shakes or protein, whey proteins with a lot of chocolate in there, just to make sure they add some muscles as far as their quest to gain weight is concerned. To stimulate kidneys, we know that our kidneys, the kidney is just like the fuel for the car. Without it, there will be a lot of dirt in our system and our body can be harmed. So if you have something that's helping you to keep your kidney in check, it means that it's something that is of health. But stay positive to the right servings and portioning. Yes, it increases appetite. So if you are somebody who is struggling to eat like myself, I can't finish my food, you can help yourself out by making sure you have some of these dirt or slot in, let's say, a portion, a bar, something small of chocolate in there just to make sure your appetite is improved on. Or you can make chocolate and beverages just to help you. So if I start, let's say, my day off with a chocolate beverage, it means that at least I've improved on my benefits, on my appetite. So I'll have the appetite to go through my snack, my lunch, my second snack, and then my dinner. And then it reduces fever. It alleviates gout symptoms. It helps pass kidney stools to increase sexual drive, and then it energizes the body. And there is this important thing. I suffered malaria, so I want to chip it in with the tamarind, the velvet tamarind, the leaves, Kweku. Can you imagine that boiling the leaves and drinking the juice takes care of plasmodium I've forgotten the flap, something that causes them.
The one that causes malaria.
So, yes, it takes care of it. And so I was really like, when I come here, even if I forget, I want to talk about it. So it takes care, as far as malaria is concerned, the leaves helps by making sure that Plasmodium falciparum, that's what it is. Your biochemistry should help me. Yes, it makes sure that it is taken care of. And that is what causes the malaria in us. So if this is something you can even boil in the house and just be taking, just to make sure you flush out plasmodium flas.
From the blood.
Yes.
All right.
Flasiparum.
All right. Fantastic. Thank you very much. We've been talking to Akosua Kunedu Yiadom, who is a state registered nutritionist. Where can we find you? Where can people who are viewers find you?
Okay. So on Instagram at the nutritionist Akosua. At the Nutritionist Akosua. On Facebook, Nutritionist Akosua.
Okay.
And then on LinkedIn, Twitter, Nutritionist Akosua. You can call me also on 0243-350206 for everything nutrition and dietetics.
All right. Fantastic. Well, thank you very much for watching this segment.
Hi there. I hope you enjoyed the show. Don't forget to subscribe, like, comment, and share with all of your friends. This is Breakfast Daily on City TV.
Join the Breakfast Daily team Monday through Fridays from 7:30 a.m. to 10. Join us for breakfast daily, only on City TV.